Hello guys, KP Shamino here with a new video for Fishing North Atlantic. And I'm going to give you guys 5 beginner's tips. So I want to thank first all my viewers, because they set most of them. And I'm going to share with them, because they are very, very important that you know that. Because it's going to make your life a lot easier. You're going to make a lot of more money. And it's going to save a lot of time. So first of all, we are going to start with number one. So the time forward. So you can do it now at 2 methods. You can do it in your boat too. I didn't know that yesterday. But how do you do it in the starting boat? So if you get out of it, you see here a watch on the wall. You just need to push E. And you can skip the time. So you're going to put your anchor out. And you can just skip the time. And you can even skip 1 week. So it's very, very good, this feature. Because in the past you just need to travel around. Or go to the harbor and forward the time. And how do you do it in the harbor? I will show you guys it really quick too. Here we go. So you just go to general and you can do just the same. So that was tip number one. Okay guys, tip number two, and very important too. So you can put markers on your map. So it's very good. So somebody said it to me after the video of yesterday, because I was hoping that they are going to implement it in the game. But it's already in the game. So if you're on a position that there is a lot of fish over there, certain fish, you just need to come to your map. You just take an icon, for example, the redfish. You just put it somewhere and you know later on where you can find certain fish species. So very, very handy, because it's a very big map. The only problem that I got at the moment is that the icons are a little bit too big. Maybe I can make them smaller, but they can be a little bit smaller in my opinion. So a very good feature too, but of course you need to know it. That was tip number two. The next tip has everything to do with the price of fish. So the price of fish is not in every harbor the same. So at the start it's very important, and later on the game it's very important too, that you know how you need to do it. So how do you can see what price a certain town or harbor got? You need to go here to finances. You click it and then you take fish prices. So you need to unlock all the harbors first. Because I got now at the moment 3. I think I need to do like a couple of more. And if you go to a harbor, you can see all the prices here that they are going to give. So the swordfish at the moment in this harbor is $35 for each kilogram. So be very aware that you know that you sell your fish in the harbor that gives the most for that fish. It can make you a lot of more money. So that was tip number 3. The next tip, that's number 4 already. So we are almost done with the video. So if you're in a harbor, sometimes it's hard to get out of the harbor. So you need to put, if I put now here a waypoint. Okay. Come on, game. So you get this. So how do you need to do it? You need to do it always like this. Then you need to zoom in. So it's not handy. So what is a solution for this problem? Very simple. Just unlock the lighthouse. You click the lighthouse. You fast travel. And you're right away in open water. So you're never going to have that problem again. That you get stuck. So you can go always to the lighthouse. I think you need to unlock it first. So here is the lighthouse. I'm not sure that I got it on the third one yet. No. But be sure that you unlock it. A very good tip to get very fast out of the harbor. And then to end the video guys. Tip number 5. Very important. I already told you guys it yesterday in my first 2 videos. But if you start with the starting boat. So you always start of course with the starting boat. You can use this fishing not only for harpoon fishing. So you see here the pirate bridge. So I had the same thought. So I saw it and I think, okay, you can do only harpoon fishing and then you can go to another fishing. No, don't start with harpoon fishing. You can fish deep line too with this boat. Just go for it. You will make a lot of more money at the start. It's a lot easier to get the fish. You will get less frustrated. So just go deep line fishing at the start. If you want to do later in the game harpoon fishing, you can always do it, but at the start I would not do it. Just take a loan if you need to buy the deep lines. You go one, two times to the sea, get 8 deep lines out, and you get your money back, pay the loan back, and then you got a very good start compared with harpooning. So that was it, guys. 5 tips and tricks that you need to know if you start the game. So thanks for watching. Have fun. Bye-bye.